yo.
Ay. Is not the causer of the timeless deaths of these Plantagenets, Henry and Edward, not as blameful as the executioner?
Thou art the cause and most accursed effect.
Thy beauty was the cause of my effect, thy beauty that did haunt me in my sleep, that I might undertake the death of all the world, that I might live 1 hour in your sweet bosom.
If I thought that, I tell thee, homicide, these nails should rend that beauty from my cheeks.
These eyes could never endure thy beauty's wrath, thou should not blemish if I stood by. Just as all the world is cheered by the sun, I am by that. That is my day, that is my life.
Death, thy life.
Curse not thyself, fair lady, thou art both.
I would I were to be revenged on thee.
It is a quarrel most unnatural to be revenged on one that loveth thee.
It is a quarrel just and reasonable to be revenged on him that slew my husband.
He bereft thy lady of thy husband to help thee to find a better husband.
His pen doth not breathe upon this earth.
He lives upon this earth that could love thee better than he ever could.
Name him.
Plantagenet.
Why, that was he.
Self same name, but of better nature.
Where is he?
Here. Why dost thou spit at me?
Would it were mortal poison for thy sake.
Never poison came from so sweet a place.
Never hung poison on a fowler toad. Out of my sight, thou dost infect my eyes.
And thine eyes, my lady, have infected mine.
Were they were basilisks to strike thee dead.
Oh, I wish they were, that I might die at once, for now they kill me with a living death. If thy revengeful heart cannot forgive, then lo, I hand thee this sharp-pointed sword. And if thou please to hide in thy true breast and set forth the soul that adoreth thee, then I lay it bare naked for the deadly stroke and humbly ask for my death upon my knee. Nay, do not pause, for I did kill King Henry, but 'twas thy beauty that provoked me. Take up the sword, or take up me.
Arise, dissembler. Though I wish thee dead, I will not be the executioner.
Then say me the word. To kill myself, and I will do it.
I have already.
No, that was in thy range. Tell me the word again, and with this hand, that for thy love did kill thy love, shall for thy love kill a far truer love. And to both shalt thou be accomplice.
I would I knew thy heart.
'Tis figured in my tongue.
I fear me both are false.
Then never a man was true.
Well, but of thy sword.
Say then my peace is made.
That you shall know hereafter.
Shall I live in hope?
All men, I hope, live so.
Vouchsafe, wear this ring.
Take is not to give.
Look how ring encompasseth thy finger, even as thy breast encloseth my poor heart. But grant me one favor at thy gracious hand, and dost grant me happiness forever.
What is it?
Presently, return to Crosby House, where afterwards I have solemnly interred at Chertsey Monastery this noble king in witness grave of my repentant tears. I shall with all expediency determine to return to you. Beseech the grant this boon.
much it joys me, too, to see you are become so penitent.
Farewell.
It is more than you deserve. But since you teach me how to flatter you, imagine I have said farewell already.
That was wow. Special. Told me to watch Jungle Book. I had never seen that.
Let me save some notes on this, just for a second.
Sure.
Because Pete, Tori, would you guys get up? Pete and Karen, okay. Just to do a little, and then I'll share notes with you guys on both scenes. This is Much Ado.
We just did for the first time today, reading it. So we just did our first reading today, so we're just gonna take a crack at it, just reading.